game. This is probably the biggest league game we've had for a long, long time, probably since the reformation, you know. I mean, Port took away 5 years ago, FA Cup winners, European football, Premier League, and now they're at the same level as us. It's just unreal, like, you know. It just shows how the club has come in leaps and bounds, you know, the last few years, you know. We've been making a real impact as well this season. You know, we've already had a giant killing. We've gone and given West Brom a game. And, you know, we've made a cup semi-final. And, you know, we're playing teams like Bloody Portsmouth, whilst above them in the league. Although they're slight favourites to beat us, Portsmouth at home to us, and they're only slight favourites. It's unreal, isn't it? You know, it's pretty much unheard of. But, yeah, we've got a pretty good bus here. We've got a good group of lads behind me, like, you know, two going with the Smile Council. May I also add, if anybody would like to know about with the Smile Council, basically they're putting on a Boxing Day and what's it called? Boxing Day and Burton away day. Basically all the money they've made from buses this season, they put it into the pot and it's made it so each of those trips is only £10 and £5 for kids. So yeah, I think people on these buses have got first dibs on the places there and anything from there, so long as it's gone, as long as they've advertised it publicly to everybody, get yourselves on there, tenner, you know. I think they want to look after the regulars first, obviously, like, you know. But fair play, it just goes to show exactly what the Smile Council is doing for the club. It's not just funding, you know, your obscure areas that tend to get overlooked by the club coffers and the directors, but, you know, they're doing things for the fans. I mean, they helped us out at the beginning of the season, you know, the Daily Choir. You know, without buses come for. So fair play to them, and what they're doing is magnificent, and I think more people should be backing them, you know. But anyway, en route, we're all happy. Everybody is well up for it today. About 1,000 of us going down, magnificent that is, you know. It just goes to show the potential, the support that we can have in this club as well, you know. It can keep growing, it's growing now, and it will always grow. Anyway, for all of you going, I hope you're all having a great day, and for those who didn't, you missed it. Well, you're probably going to miss a good one, but we'll wait and see. Every trip's good when you're also anyway, like, you know, we always have a good time with the boys, but going there and getting 3 points, it just makes it all that more special, and if we get 3 points today, it will be awesome. Anyway, awesome. Have a kind of. Okay, so, Cully said last week, you scratch your lung, for fuck's sake. So, Cully said last week when we were at Kidderman, so last week it's fancy dress, and the only person to take notice is this sad bastard here. So, today he is being called Saint Prickleus. And he's going to sing Barbie Girl tonight, whether he likes it or fucking not. We're going to make a lot of money on YouTube, we are, with it. So Saint Prick, give us your thoughts on the day and how you think we're going to do.
I'm just so proud of how we've done in the last 5 years. 5 years ago, Portsmouth were beating Newcastle in the Premier League. 5 years ago, we were beating Russian Diamonds in the Football League, in the FA Trophy. So far, the last 5 years.
It's great, isn't it, mate? Prediction for the score today, then?
I'm going for 1-0.
Two?
I'm going for Harry Worley.
Harry Worley?
Yep.
Ah, big defender's goal. Not a lot, in it?
Yep.
Oh, well, that's great.
Right, sir, big goal. They just appointed a new manager. Get up,
so, so let's bring it down there. Let's bring it down to Rob, your head elf. And obviously I emphasise the head part of the head elf. Right, Rob, same question to you, my son.
Score?
Well, what the trip means to you, and basically
what you... How far we've come has been phenomenal for the last 5 years. And today we're going to win 2-0.
2-0?
Yeah.
Goal scorers?
Yakubu and Jolly.
Fantastic, yeah. I'm hoping for the Jolly goal today, that would be good. If he starts, man, he didn't start against Peterborough.
Yeah,
he did start against Peterborough. Who didn't start? Who am I thinking of who didn't start against Peterborough? someone didn't start who I thought should have started.
Did
Jordan start against Peterborough? Yeah, he did. Who should have started against Peterborough? Yeah. Someone didn't start against Peterborough. Oh no, Kidderminster Jordan didn't start against him. That's right, yeah.
Yeah. That's why me as well, to be honest.
Right, deal then. Well, thanks for your time there, Rob. Enjoy your day.
Hey,
who else wants to make a complete swat of themselves on my blog then? Well, there's one with his finger, eh? Hey, Terry. Hello, mate. That's it. You're sucked in now. Right. What do you reckon today, mate?
Oh, just one of my friends said, you know, it's another weird thing, born in the league, you know. You know, after food, you know, can't believe it. Like, it'll be a good game, it's a good football inside. And I think it's going to be a lot of goals. I think it's going to be a 3-2 county.
Yeah? Who do you think's going to be the goal scorers then?
Well, I think Washington will pop up for one. Jolly, I think, deserves one. And perhaps Jack, head on the half post.
Head up on the egg. From the Yak, we're thinking then. Fantastic. Well, let's see what happens when we get down there, eh, boys?
Yeah.
Nice one, cheers for your time. So still not half time. There's not what I call a great deal in the game at the moment. A couple of chances at both ends. They're somewhat more clean cut, but that doesn't really matter. It's anyone's game, really, second half. Conor Washington's got off injured. I hope that's not serious. I hope we're not going to miss him in the game then as well, in other games. So, yeah, you know, it's, well, I've got to be fair, right? Craig started off singing really lately, you know, everybody was up for it, and for whatever reason, it's just died off in here. Everyone's just lost the will to even bother, like, you know, and it's a bit disheartening, like, you know, when it's just our same group singing over and over, you know, and no one wants to join. I don't expect everyone to join in with every song, but at least make a bit of effort, like, you know, we're making the effort, so, you know, we'll see what we can bring second half. 2-0. Hopefully it stays this way. We'll be back another. Happy days. Come on. On the motorway, like, you know, what an atmosphere. Oh, there you go, what a legend the driver is as well. I got some light now, fantastic. For me, that was a solid team performance. How do you sum up a win against Portsmouth, who 5 years ago were in the Premier League? They go in there and beating them. I mean, beating them at home with their weakened team was pretty special. Going there and winning 2-0, you know, in front of 1,000 of our fans. As I've said on Facebook, the good times just keep coming. And may they continue. As far as I'm concerned, this is absolutely great. You know, all the best times of my life have been following this football club. And the best times I'm ever going to have are going to be following this football club. So keep it rolling and let's hope we can keep it going. Promotion push, it's got to be on there. We've got to start believing in it like we did last year. So let's go for it. Okay, sorry about the brightness there, Barry. Take it away today.
Great performance. Kenny fans great again. Away as normal, as home. And just a shit place to go. A lot of fans, but we got our 3 points. Come on!
Excellent, mate. Do you have a good day then, yeah?
Oh, brilliant.
It's a good trip on the bus.
Every week or what?
What's that?
Play it every week.
That would be nice, wouldn't it? We're undefeated against them. We've 100% records.
Barry needs a piss. Barry needs a piss.
Right, yeah.
You're going to believe us. And now you're going to believe us. And Barry needs
a piss. What do you want? I'll do a few. I'm a ledge. What do you want to know?
Your thoughts on today?
First 20 minutes, 15, he's all over him. We had trouble in. Second half, we smashed him.
Get the ball on the
little
deck,
little chavs in the corner, giving them a mouth, walked off. And that was it, as simple as that. Fletcher shit himself as usual, giving them a mouth. They walked off and Fletcher shit himself. Fletch, what's all about me? Master, you know. Calling you out. Right. And Tom. And Tom is.
Call him out. Tom's for me.
Call him out. Call him Fletch out. Call Fletch out.
Fuck me, Tom.
Call Fletch out. Tom. Call Fletch out.
Give your thoughts, Tom. What's your thoughts, Tom?
I think we're becoming a bogey team for Portsmouth at the moment. We've got 100% record against them. And, I couldn't be happier, to be honest.
Fantastic.
Would have been nice if it was 3-0.
Yeah. How do you think it was when Danny Cole came on instead of Washington?
That's going to change the game. Keep the ball on the deck, though.
I had a good feeling, to be honest. I mean, Danny Cole's been pretty decent for us lately, you know, especially this season. I think, it's the same about Connor coming off, but.
Gotta mention
Lenny
as well, man. Two fantastic
points. Oh,
Costa Coffee.
Yeah.
Costa Coffee.
Here's a very, very important question. Ricky Gervais. Are you gonna stay awake? Do it. Right, this is how Healy does it. Healy. I'll do the for you. Just got to do the ends.
Do the actions.
Come on, Dark Alepsy, do so.
You've got more tits than friends.
Sorry,
that's quite harsh.
Jesus, yeah. How do you think today went?
What's your thought?
How do I think today went?
Yes, what's your thoughts?
I've already said my bit, but I'll say it again.
We'll say it again for all of us, because we didn't heard you.
The good times just seem to keep coming, and may they keep coming.
Bo's going to bum you.
It was awesome, though, wasn't it?
Bo is trying to rape you.
Trying to
make
you.
Get out on camera.
There's no try, there you go. It's all.
Funny is.
Feel the finger.
No, I thought the performance was,
Hello?
How do I put it? It was solid, you know? First, they had a couple of shots, took time during the first half, they looked like scoring, other than that, they didn't. And in the second half, you could just see that the game was going to go our way eventually, as long as we got the goal and taking our chances is a big thing. It's cost us in the last two games, but it didn't cost us a thing because we took the chances that we had. So I'm really happy, to be honest with you.
Danny Crowe has took a lot of criticism of everyone.
Yeah.
How do you feel his performance was when he came on for Washington?
I think Healy mentioned it, or Tom, someone by there mentioned it, that that could have changed the game. I could have changed the game. Yeah, because when you put the ball over the top, they're Washington, right? When you're running on the balls constantly and constantly, it's going to burn you out eventually. And if he's injured, that could be a result of that. You know, it's just too much for him. Sandy Croke and hold the ball up and spread the play so more people can get forward into the game. So, yeah, I think Danny Crowe has come under undeserved criticism, and today I hope that these people that have been criticising him will wake up and realise what he does for this team.
He's always given 100% and chasing the ball down, hasn't he?
Yeah, he does give 100%.
One more thing.
Yeah.
Obviously, Pompey are League 2 now, and they're still bringing 15,000 hardcore fans. It's got another lot of me, not be doing well, but it's good, though, isn't it? 15,000 fans.
Yeah. You've got to admire it, really, haven't you? You've got to think, if we drop down a few divisions ourselves, would we still be taking 3,500 to 4,000 fans to rugby?
That's 12,000 fans short of what they're doing every week at the home.
They practically fill their stadium every game, and their support, is really second to none in this division. We're growing, we're pushing on, and we're attracting more of Newport's fickle football fans to start coming more often, and it's great. But then we got a long way to go before we can hit the support that Portsmouth got. But then hopefully when we do hit that support, we'll be in the Championship or Premiership within 10 years or something. That's the dream. But to be honest, today, being back in the Football League is not a good place for me.
Thank you, that's Chris Taff. We should.
That's wicked. Right, who else am I going to bother?
Scratchy,
come here. Scratchy.
Santa.
Said that he was going to sing Barbie Girl on the karaoke tonight, and I was going to record it and make millions on YouTube and share some of it with him. Now, he's retracting that and saying that he's not going to do it. He is now under pressure to sing it.
Scratchy! 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 Scratchy!
Scratchy! Scratchy! Say Prickless.
Sing a song.
You just roped yourself into the blog.
Hey,
are you blinded?
Am I looking all right?
No, you're not.
Oh, okay.
Joey Essex.
Yeah.
Amalgamated with Vanessa Feltz. That was what I was thinking of.
Hey.
Joey Essex slash Vanessa Feltz. Gabo. Right. What are we saying then? How did you find it today?
Oh, I found it amazing. Loving County Away Day. Can't beat the County Away Day.
Yeah. Now, you're quite new to the Caney scene yourself, aren't you?
Yeah.
You're one of our new fans. Have you fallen in love with the club like a lot of us have?
Yeah.
Will you be there till you die now?
Till I die. Till in the grave. Even in the grave.
So you're exactly what we're looking for, People like yourself starting to come to the games and stuff like that, it's great.
You've got social support for your whole team.
And that's what we're trying to encourage in Newport right now. So hopefully more following your footsteps and come along with us.
Yeah, come along.
But anyway, I'm going to call it on that because the space on my phone because of all these videos is starting to wear thin. So cheers, Bo, and cheers, everybody else. It's been a great trip.
Right then, so we had a good day yesterday then. I know I did. It was, for me, one of my best away trips with the County. A lot of people are saying it was their best one. But, for me, nothing beats Hereford. It's going to take a lot to beat Grimsby away as well. And Brighton away was amazing. West Brom away, I know we lost, but it was still a good trip. Pompey's definitely up there with them. But Hereford's my main one, But it was just good to see us bounce back again. I think I mentioned it on Facebook a couple of times that, we bounced back. We always seem to bounce back somehow. I mean, we're 8-2 cups, but we just showed that we're going to make the most of the only thing we got left to play for, and that's to look for a promotion push, and back-to-back promotions would be unreal, really, wouldn't it? I think we got the resources, the potential and support, and we've definitely got the manager and the backroom staff and the squad at the moment as well. I mean, so far, yeah, we've had a couple of games where we've been beaten, you know, pretty badly. But we've outplayed some teams so much this season, I think we could go up and definitely make a mark on League One. But then even if we don't go up this year, I think we're well equipped to put a proper full-on assault on the league then. You know, maybe look at the title next year. There's endless possibilities now, and that's what I'm loving about being in the Football League again. You know, the possibilities. I mean, we were one game away from possibly drawing a big club like Man United or Liverpool in the FA Cup. You know, we played two big clubs, Brighton and West Brom, in the League Cup. We've had two big clubs here in the Johnson's Paint Trophy in Portsmouth and Peterborough. So, I mean, I'm just revelling in it right now, and I suppose all of you guys are doing the same. So, you can tell when Newport County are doing well. Neil Cork doesn't come up on the message board. He's been absent of late. He's too busy sharpening his knife, I'd imagine, ready to wait for us to do something wrong, and then he'll come in. I'm surprised that he didn't come in with Kidderminster. Well, he might have. I don't check the message boards that much. You know, it's not a great deal of conversations that, you know, I like to get myself involved in on there anymore. So, but yeah, fair play. I got to admit, times are looking good now. And like I mentioned before, the good times just keep coming. So may they continue to come. All right then, guys. On now until Wimbledon next Saturday. Up the county.